bronze, did any of you have brown spots this year? I had a big brown spot, right? You get them every couple of years, big brown spot, no grass was growing. And so I bought the seeds, got some nice soil, and tossed the seeds into that, watered it. And when Scott told me you should water it twice a day, then actually some grass started growing. But what grew even faster and thicker was weeds. It's as if that package of seeds that I had sown was a package of weeds, because they grew. I hadn't seen weeds like that for a long time. And I wondered why they were just in this one patch where I had sown the seeds. It's frustrating, but it helps me to understand the parable a little bit this morning. This morning, there's thousands of pastors around the world that are preaching this story about the parable of the sower, because most Christian churches follow the same pericopes. They follow the same readings every Sunday, so they're going to be preaching. You're going to hear Pastor Craig's version of this, and it may not sound like anybody else's. The seed that he's talking about is the Word of God. But even more than that, it's the gospel. It's the gospel in its purest and most powerful form. The seed that Jesus is talking about is the God's unconditional love for the world. That's it. It's God's unconditional love for the world. And he's tossing these seeds out, not just in the springtime, every day, every moment. God is tossing these seeds out to the world, and not much is happening. Not much is happening to these seeds, right? If you watch the news and listen to the stories that are happening, right? The world isn't filled with love. It's filled with fear and hate and distrust of one another. And yet every day, God is out there tossing out the seeds of love. One of the problems now, you know, we're talking, we believe that COVID has devastated the church. COVID has speeded things up, but it has not devastated the church. One of the real problems in the church is there aren't going to be many sowers of the seed. Last year, there were 5 full-time people at the seminary. 5. Jeff, when you went, how many were there? 80? 90?
Well, not that many.
Weren't there?
20.
Oh, 20. In your class.
In my class.
Right, but yeah. For the whole, there was probably 8. Yeah. When I came here in 1978, there were probably over 100 students at the seminary, filling all the positions. And you know how many Lutheran churches there were in Saskatchewan alone, right? All the different pockets, the Norwegian pockets and the German pockets, they all had Lutheran churches. And many of those are closing now, unfortunately. And going forward, are we going to have pastors? Are we going to have pastors that are going to sow the seeds that Jesus came to bring to the world? I remember when I was a kid growing up in the Lutheran church, we were so intent on mission work. Millions of dollars went in the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod for missionary work. And we sent missionaries out to all parts of the world to evangelize and to make them Christian. Do you know what's happening now? People in those countries are coming here to Canada to serve the Lutheran churches because we don't have enough pastors to spread the word. That was an irony that I don't think any of us saw. Thank God we have them. One of the biggest problems, though, of the sowing of the seeds, the sowing of the gospel, is that we've changed the seeds. Maybe it's like my original story. Maybe somebody put some bad seed in that bag that I was throwing out. And unfortunately, the Christian church and the different Christian churches have changed this powerful word of the gospel. This powerful, unconditional love. This love that says in Romans chapter 8, there is nothing. There is nothing that can happen to you in this life. There is nothing in all creation that can ever separate you from this love. The church has changed that message. Oh, Paul must not have meant those things, because there's lots of things that can separate you from God's love. Your sexual orientation can separate you from God's love. If you're divorced or not, it can separate you from God's love. If you are baptized or not baptized, it can separate you from God's love. And on the list goes, until there are so many things, it seems impossible that we can ever stay in a relationship with God. The powerful message, the gospel message that Jesus came and is still tossing out to the world. The world doesn't hear it. It's not being preached. So many people don't believe it. So many people, as it said in the gospel, are worried about the things that concern wealth and possessions, that they're not concerned about any message that God might have for them. Spirituality is dying. People aren't walking by faith anymore. But those of us who hear the message and believe this message of love, it has to resound in our hearts. So not only do we believe the message, we share the message with everybody that we come into contact with, especially our family. Our families have to know that there's nothing that they can do that will ever separate them from our love and from God's love. Our community of faith must know this also. Our province, our country, our world. It's a powerful message. It needs to be heard. Amen.
Amen. Let us rise.